In this video, I'll be demonstrating some tricks that you can use to configure your recording sessions inside of Pro Tools to make it easier to do things like jump around from one section of your song to another section of your song, or do things like focus on individual instruments or groups of instruments if you know that you're going to be doing a lot of editing of them. Now, it does take a little bit of extra work on the front end to set up your session to do all these things. However, if you do it, a lot of times this can, in fact, speed up a lot of your workflow for the remaining time that you're having to edit in that session. I'm going to be showing you a couple different things. First is how you can use memory locations to do a bunch of different things, and also how to use Zoom presets. So let's first start out with the memory locations. Many people are familiar with the basics of memory locations and what you can use them for. So for instance, as the name would suggest, you can have your computer kind of memorize the different locations or store in its memory the parts of your song that you're interested in marking. So if you want to mark the introduction, the chorus, and the verse, just a matter of bringing the playback head or the cursor to that location and marking it on my computer keyboard, I can use function and enter. That's going to create a location. I'll call this intro. Next up is my first verse. I know that it's at this location right here. I can create another one, call it verse one. My chorus comes in right here. I can continue to do this for the remainder of the different sections of my song. And then all you have to do is just click on these different memory locations and the playback head will jump to those different parts. So if you just want to quickly jump to the first verse, listen to that. Jump to the chorus or the intro. This is kind of the simplest way that you can use memory locations. I'll come back to these in a little while and show you some more advanced features of how to use memory locations. Next up though, I want to show you Zoom presets. The idea with Zoom presets is you can set the relative level that you've either zoomed in or zoomed out on your session and set them to hotkeys or these buttons up here. So for instance, the most basic way to zoom is to use the zoom tool. You can zoom in and out like this. You hold the option key, you can zoom out. So the way that I like to do it in my sessions is to kind of start from a global perspective or the broad, big picture view of my session and set this to one of the zoom presets and then kind of zoom in at these different levels and set them as different presets. So if I start out, click this and make it zoom preset one by holding it down, I can save this as my zoom preset, the global view of my session, then zoom in a little bit farther to a certain level. Maybe this is good. Set this as zoom preset two. Zoom in very close. Zoom preset three. The thing to know about these zoom presets is it actually doesn't necessarily zoom into that particular section of the song. It always zooms to the relative level based on where the cursor is. So for instance, if I want to zoom out to zoom preset one, click it here, I can see the broad view of my session. If I move the cursor to this part right here and I click on zoom preset two, it's going to zoom into that level that I set, but based on wherever my cursor is now. So you can see the cursor is still there. Zoom in more, zoom preset three. And as you might expect, the keyboard shortcuts for these things are just the numbers on the actual computer keyboard. Zoom out to one, zoom in. You can zoom in even further and set up to five presets. Now, this is really handy for jumping around to different parts of your song. When you're playing back, you might want to zoom out. If you want to go in for editing, you click on one of the presets, and now you're right in, focused on where you want to edit. Coming back to memory locations now, you can use memory locations not only just to mark the different places of your song, but to actually zoom to that section of your song too. So it's kind of like a zoom preset and memory location in one. Let me show you that. Let's say this is my next chorus, and I'm going to zoom in and just focus on this part of my song. So I'll zoom in really far, fill the screen with this chorus, go back to my memory locations window. I'm going to create a new one now. Call this chorus 2. Now, what I had selected before is just this marker. You can actually do things like move on and use a selection tool. What this is going to do is allow me to set a location or a memory and store in memory the fact that I've selected with the cursor just chorus 2. So if I've got it in loop record, I don't have to go in and find that location of the song and drag it out the cursor just to focus on that area. I just set up this selection right here. I can go in and click on zoom settings now and click OK. I've got chorus 2. You'll see that it's has different things over here for the selection and the zoom. That way now, if I go back to different part of my song, verse 1, now I click on chorus 2, it zooms me right back in on that chorus, and it has highlighted that part so I can just listen back just to that part if that's the way I want to edit it. So that's just a different way to use the memory locations, kind of in the same way as you would with zoom presets to zoom in and out. But in this case, you have the ability to control not only the zoom, but the location in your track where you're going to zoom. The last thing I want to show you that's pretty cool with the memory locations is you can actually set it up so that you only focus on certain tracks. So for instance, let's say I want to focus on my electric guitar tracks, get rid of the other ones. So I'll just hide all these other ones and see what I've got going on with my electric guitar tracks. So I've got all these auxiliary tracks going on with reverb and my electric guitar bus, and then I have these electric guitars going on here. Now you can go in with the memory location, create another one, call this guitars. Click on tracks show and hide. Now I can go from things like verse 1, zoom out on this, then click on guitars. If I show all my other tracks now that I just hid, I can click on these things like chorus 2. If I click on guitars, it's going to hide all these other ones and just allow me to focus on these individual instruments. So you could do this kind of thing if you want to set it up for guitars, for drums. It's really just a matter of being as creative as possible and speeding up your workflow. If you know that you're going to be doing a lot of editing on guitars, you want to group them together or group together all your drums or percussive elements. You know, it's really up to you to figure out what's going to speed up your time when you're actual editing. So hopefully this video gave you an opportunity to look at some different functions and things that go on behind the scenes of Pro Tools that you can use. They're kind of workflow improvements, but you just have to weigh out for yourself, you know, which things are going to be helpful for you and which things are just going to be too much time to set up.